Hello, beautiful souls. I am Valeria Maritza at Healing Through You. I am an infinite being of light, and so are you. Today, I want to talk to you about being stuck physically and emotionally. I have had so many examples of this being stuck in your head, pretty much. From so many people that I was like, okay, this has to be a topic I need to talk about. When something happens in our lives and we're like, oh my goodness, this is terrible, or how are we going to deal with this? Or, you know, all of those things that come into our awareness as soon as something happens that we feel is difficult or challenging, right? And then we begin to think of all the different reasons and ways of why this is so terrible. Where those are just thoughts. And remember, your thoughts become a reality. So the more that you think of the dread of how difficult, of how horrible whatever is happening, the more that you make it real, the more that you make things more difficult to handle, and all of the stuff that you're dreading, you're making it a reality just by putting your energy into that energy. Does that make sense? Where it's just a thought, it's just you get to choose how you feel. So I'm going to give you an example to give you a little bit more understanding of this. There was this lady, an elderly lady, very active still, living in her own house, and the rains came and it flooded, and part of the basement wall broke, and the whole basement flooded, and she had no electricity, and then had to wait for insurance to look at all of this. And it wasn't just her, obviously other homes were affected by it as well. And then she had to find somebody to take care of this, and you know how all of that stuff happens. Didn't have electricity for a while, had to take her clothes and wash them elsewhere, all of the things. And she's older, right? She's like in her late 70s. So her family immediately offered, come move in with us while this is happening. No. Okay, so here I gave you the whole like of what happened. It's like, oh my gosh, this is terrible, blah, blah, blah. Like all the things that she has to do in order to take care of it. Oh, and it's going to cost so much money. Where's the money going to come from, right? So immediately, family members invited her to move in with them, which, by the way, she had been invited to move in with them earlier, but didn't want to because of the, she likes her independence, and I understand that, right? We all like our independence. And so, no. So she's carrying her laundry back and forth, right? She's sleeping there at night without heat. She's doing all of these things in this home. Well, it's not functional, and this is like in the cold months, not now that it's warm. But she's avoiding it. Then, oh, this is going to cost so much money. Okay, so other family members offering her to pay, and then seeing the damages and where the home is and thinking, you know, it'd be better if she just moved out of there and just get a new house in a different place, and it may be closer to family than where she's at. No, she says no. Just buy the house. Okay, what am I giving you? I'm giving you the reluctance of the human mind, the human being, of staying where they are and dealing with all the problems and making it difficult for ourselves when, in fact, there are so many other, what? Possibilities. Possibilities of moving into someone else's home, having heat, not having to drag your laundry back and forth, you know, and doing all of this work, not needing to wait for the contractors to come and fix your home while you're there and while you're dealing with the house not being functional. Having a brand new home, what about that? Okay, we have a brand new home, much closer. Oh no, how are we going to move? There are people who do these things out there. There are people who actually, that's their job. They go and they move in, they move your house. You're like, oh, there's no money. There's people in the family offering to pay for what you need. See what I mean? The universe is infinite, abundant, limitless. There are so many ways to change what can happen only if you're open to it and then accept it. That's just one example that I have, right? There's another example here. Someone had a family member in the hospital, very far away from their home, like over an hour's drive each way. Oh, I don't have any time to sleep, but there's not enough time for resting. There's like all of this traveling. I need to travel at night. I don't like traveling at night. All of these things. Okay, there are possibilities. How about you stay at a hotel? No, don't want to do that. What about this and that? What about this? What, I just want to be home. Well, if the thing is that you're just going to go home and sleep and then you're traveling all this time, why don't you just sleep at a hotel that's closer? No. Okay. Other options. Maybe it would be good to rent a home or an apartment or something close to the hospital, since the person might be there for a while and this situation doesn't seem to. No, want to be home, right? So this is what I'm talking about, the no's. We are so quick to put out a no out there because we're so comfortable with what we have, and we believe that the only way to get through them is through struggle and pain. And that's not true. It's true for us who decide that that's the way that we want to go. It is true for us who decide that that's the only way. And we put no's to all of the different examples and ideas and solutions that the universe is giving you. We can't make anyone choose these things, but we are so inside our own heads of things must be done this way and nothing else is available. When you say that to yourself, you say that to the universe, and then the universe gives you just that. The universe gives you no other options but the ones that you have in front. But if you just ask, what else is possible? This is a tool. Ask to the universe, what else is possible here? Or how does it get any better than this? These are access toolbars. You just ask. You're not looking for an answer. It's interesting. A lot of times I post this or I answer on a text or on a message or on a post to someone when they say something, and I say, how does it get? And I put, how does it get any better than this? And then they answer, it doesn't. Well, guess what you're doing? When you're saying it doesn't, it's not going to get any better than that. By the way, that tool, how does it get any better than this? It's a tool that you ask when whether things are going well or whether things are going badly. So let's say, for example, you find a 25 cents on the street and you go, oh my gosh, this is great. How does it get any better than this? Well, you might walk by and find a dollar bill next by that. Oh my gosh, how does it get any better than this? You might keep going and find something else on the street, maybe a chain that somebody lost. Oh, how does it get any better than this? And you keep going, right? So each time that you say it, the universe hears you and gives you more. You're not looking for things on the ground to pick up. You're just asking to the universe, and the universe will deliver to you in a way that you may not expect at all. Now, when you get something and you're like, okay, it doesn't get any better than this, then what happens? You're telling the universe, it's not getting any better than this. It's not going to get any better than this. And so the universe stops delivering to you. It's the same thing with possibilities. What else is possible here? These are my options. This is the thing that's happening. What else is possible? Your job is to ask the question and put it out there into the universe. It is not to look for the answer and the solution, because you don't know all of the possibilities that are out there. You are living in this very small, constricted space of possibilities that only your human mind can conceive according to your experiences and beliefs. But the universe is infinite and abundant. And so when you ask the universe, how does it get any better than this? Or what else is possible? And then you just let it go. You don't look for an answer. Then the universe shows you the different ways and possibilities that you can go. And then your job is to recognize it and take action on that, right? So there are so many, and I know that you can relate to this, and you can think of things that have happened in your life personally or on other people that you know, and you can think of different ideas to to help others, perhaps not for yourself, but other people might have ideas to help you. And watch yourself. Watch, what are you saying? What are you saying no to? Are you open enough to even listen to the possibilities, or are you happy enough in the mess that you're in for whatever reason, and there's no judgment here, that you're saying no to things, right? You're just saying no because of whatever reasons you may have, and it's okay. That's your life. It's your path. It's your choice. No judgments. What I'm saying here is that it doesn't have to be that way if you don't want it to be. If you choose that you want something better, then put it out there into the universe and stop saying no. There's been many movies about the yes, saying yes, saying yes to everything, right? And how life changes when that happens. There's a new trend with kids that I heard about, which I thought was ridiculous, but apparently it's a thing, where you give your child a yes day for their birthday or something like that. Like everything they ask that day, you say yes to and see how everything changes, right? I think it's a ridiculous thing because, I don't know, I usually don't say no to my child unless it's like something that he's going to get hurt. So I don't know how that works. But these things are all coming out of the consciousness that there is something else out there. There are different possibilities, and you have this possibility at your fingertips, or maybe I should say at your tongue tip. All you have to say it, invoke it, trust, believe, and let it go. Don't look for the answers. Don't look for the answers. It is the fear of change and the fear of something new that keeps us from allowing this. And also the fear of, well, really bringing something completely different, right? That's change, something completely different. How would it be if I had to move and sell my home of, I don't know how many years, where all of my memories are, to go live close to the hospital or nursing home where my loved one is going to be, to make things easier for me so that I can go see them more, right? More often, more easily. What's the point of keeping your home full of memories if the only time you're going to go there is to sleep and then go back, right? There's no time really to take care of it. Everyone's situation is different. There's so much going on, right? But we are living life only in the now. The now is the only thing that exists. We tend to save money in the bank or wherever for the future, which doesn't exist. The only thing that exists is the now. This is why people who make money and spend money and make money and spend money, and there's like nothing in the bank, they're living in the now. And you're saying they're not looking for the future. What's going to happen when they get old? What's going to happen? The universe is going to continue to provide to them because that's what they're expecting. They're expecting more money to come in and take care of them as they go. I know this doesn't make sense. You have been, all of us, brainwashed into believing that life works in a linear way. That served us for many, many years. But now it's all changing. Now we're all moving into quantum leaps, quantum energy. Things just manifesting out of thin air, literally. It happens. It has happened many times. Instant or instantaneous healings, miraculous healings from one day to the next. They happen. They're happening all over the world. But these things happen when we are open to the possibilities. That's all you have to do, is be open to the possibilities. Ask, how does it get any better? Ask, what else is possible, right? Somebody says, these are your options. Let's say you go to the doctor and they give you some really bad news about some disease that you have, illness. Ask, how does it get any better than this, right? You work with what you have, but always trusting in the universe, that the universe has your back. And if you choose all of the infinite possibilities that there are there, you may actually ride through the wave without needing to go through the pain and suffering if you choose to. Many, many years back, I needed to sell my home, and I needed to sell it fast. And I found a buyer. I may have told this story before, I don't remember. And everything was going well, and I'm at work, and I get a phone call from the inspector who says, hey, you have asbestos in the basement. I had no idea. I had been living there. I had no idea. I don't even know how I bought the house without knowing that. But anyway, my world crashed in like a second. Oh my goodness, I have asbestos. This is a big deal. The buyer's not going to want it. It's going to delay everything. Maybe I'll lose the buyer. All of these thoughts in my head, right? Because I'm human, so I have these thoughts. But then I immediately, after that, after all of those thoughts went through my head, thought, okay, what's my next point of action? What do I do? And I just asked. And you know what? The answer came. Let me tell you, I was not doing this healing thing back then. This is just intuition. I just knew what to do. And so I asked, what's the next point? And then it came to me. And it came, look for an asbestos removal company. And so I did. I went online. I said, I searched. I looked at a company. I picked up the phone and I called, right? Action. Take action on the idea that comes through. Picked up the phone, made an appointment. I think it was Monday or Tuesday when I got the phone call, and they could come within 2 or 3 days. They did. I think they came on Wednesday, and by Thursday it was done. That fast. It was that fast. Not even a week. It was painless. They went and took care of the issue without me even needing to be home. I went to work. The key I gave to my realtor, they took care of it. How does it get any better than this? Seriously. I went back home. It was beautiful. The whole basement, gorgeous. It looks so much better than before. Like, oh my gosh, I've been living with this stuff. It was asbestos. And look how much nicer it looks now. I should have done this before. Of course, I didn't know it was asbestos, but there you go, right? This is what I'm talking about. It's not staying in the energy of the dread, not staying in the energy of fear, not buying into all of these thoughts and ideas that people tell you are difficult and painful. When you buy into it, that's when you make it real for yourself. Very important. Don't buy into it. It's a new paradigm right now. You do not need to continue living in this world believing the old, heavy, linear ways of doing things. Work your way through your spirit, through your inner knowing, through asking the universe, how does it get any better? Letting it go. What else is possible? Let it go. And then moving forward and with the belief and understanding that everything happens for a reason, a good reason for you, for your soul's growth. And you'll understand it better later on. You don't need to understand it now. You just need to trust that the universe has your back, or the angels, or God, or whomever it is that you believe in and you are working with. With that, I'm letting you go. Till next time, if you like this message, please like it, please rate this podcast and share it, so other people can also find the messages. Much love to you, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.